table with me for just a few moments. What I'm going to talk on today is examination time. It says it's examination time. It says for every student, when the school year ends, all the lessons that were taught in the previous semester are given back to the students in examination form. Whether the questions are multiple choice, true, false, discussion, or essay questions, the students are required to sit through a proper examination to test the individual's progress during the school year. Many students experience anxiety, they feel the pressure, or they rush to cram all the information that they can in order just to pass the class. Those are the people that are just borderline, you're just trying to pass. This is due to because you procrastinated, you were either weren't here, you were absent all the time, you didn't have time management skills, you didn't study to show yourself approved. But do you recall the lessons of yesterday? The lesson that the just shall live by faith. The lessons of trust. The lessons of love. The lessons that you can take to stand against the wiles of the devil. Do you remember the ministry assignments that God has given you? Ephesians 6, 10 and 11 says, finally, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Be put on the full armor of God that you can stand against the wiles of the devil. Imagine God has placed you in an isolated classroom so that he can test what lies in the depths of your heart. He wants to test your work ethic so that he can begin to open up more doors for you. Revelations 3, 8, and the A part of it, it says, I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. So, I'm going to give you the cliff notes, the dummy's guide to this examination that God is about to give us all. So, are you ready? If you need to take out some notes, you can take out your notes. But I'm going to give you the keys to pass the test. First part. Be on time. The examination starts at promptly at one time or another. You can't be 5, you can't be 10, you can't be 15 minutes late. You have to be on time, and you have to be ready in your seat.
Yes.
For when you'll be on time, you'll be glad, like it says in Psalms 122. It says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, and our feet will be standing in thy gates, O Jerusalem. So if you want to be glad when you get to your test, you have to be on time. That means, for me too, that means for church.
You're
on time for work, that means on church. Because when we come together on one accord, in Acts 2 and 1, they said the day of Pentecost, when it came, they were all in one place on one accord. So when you want Pentecost to come, we got to be on one accord. That's one. The second part of the test is reading the instructions. What did God tell you to do? You know, King Saul in 1 Samuel 15, the Lord instructed him to wipe out the Amalekites. But Saul didn't follow the Lord's instruction, and it cost him his throne. So you have to remember that you have to do what God told you to do. Remember that your examination is personal. You don't need anybody else's notes.
Come on now.
You don't have to cheat.
All right.
And you don't have to imitate. For Philippians 2:12b says, continue to work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Now, here comes the part of the test. The first part of the test has multiple choice questions. The first question is, can you control your emotions? God wants to examine your emotions because he cannot put babies on the front line to do his work. John 4:4 says, You, dear children, are from God and have overcome them because the one who is in you is greater than he who is in the world. Hebrews 5:14 says, but solid food is for the mature, who by constant use have trained themselves to distinguish good and evil. So if you can control your emotions, you can distinguish between good and evil. You can't get mad at your sister because she didn't speak to you today.
Come on now.
You can't get mad at your brother because he didn't come by and see you. You can't get mad because somebody went to somebody else's house. You can't get upset when the pastor didn't say, hey, sister, how you doing? You can't do that.
Come on now.
You have to be able to control your emotions for this examination.
Come on now.
Next question. It says, it's a strength test. Can you stand in the face of adversity?
Right.
Ephesians 6:13 says, therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after everything you've, and after everything you've done, stand. So you have to be able to stand and be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. You have to be strong. You have to, you know, no matter what they say, no matter what they do, no matter how they how hard they hit us out of life, we have to be strong.
Come on, come on.
The next question. Does your character and your conduct match up with what you say? Do you possess the character to represent God on the front line? Ephesians 6:14-15 says, stand firm then with the belt of truth buckled around your waist.
Come on now.
And the breastplate of righteousness in place. And your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. Does your character and conduct match up with what you say? Examine yourself. The next, the fourth question is an essay question. This means it's time to show your work. It's time to show your work. Is your faith and trust truly in the Lord? James 2:14 says, so also faith, if it hath not worked, it is dead itself. So do you have the faith to stand? Do you trust in the Lord? As Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not to thine own understanding, and in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. He will direct your path. He will direct your path. He will. He'll do it. Not you, but he will. That's the answer to that question. So it's time to show your work. But no, just when you think that you've gotten over the test and you got your essay question down, he throws a curveball in there. He says, do you have a stable mindset? And can you bring your fleshly thoughts under subjection? Philippians 4:8 says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, and whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. You have to get your mindset right. 2 Corinthians 10:5, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bring it into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. So can you bring your thoughts together under subjection? Yes, you answered the essay question. Yes, you got through the multiple choice, but it's your mind right. The next part is true and false. You have to beware of the Ishmaelites. Those are people that are birthed out of flesh. Genesis 6:12 says, Genesis 6:12 describes them as wild people that come against, come in opposition against you. Also, you have to beware of false prophets and deceitful men. For Matthew 24:11 says, and many false prophets shall arise and deceive many.
That's the word.
So can you distinguish between the false prophet and the real prophet? Can you know what's the voice of God and what's not the voice of God? Finally, there's, this is the final question. It says, will you pray at all times? Will you pray when it seems like you can't pray? First Thessalonians 5:17 says, pray without ceasing. James 5:16 says, confess your faults to one another. That means my brother and my sister, if I've done something and I feel bad about it, I'm not going to let the devil take my mind. I'm going to come and tell my brother, look, brother, this is what I'm struggling with.
There it is.
And pray for one another that ye may be healed. For the effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous man availeth much. Will you pray at all times? Finally, the reason why God is giving you this examination, he's setting us up like he did the church of Ephesus. See, the church of Ephesus was at a prominent location in Asia Minor. Everybody came through Asia Minor. Everybody traded in Asia Minor. Everybody was there. All types of people came through the region. And it was important that Christians, it's important that Light of Life was are strong enough to withstand all the temptation. Walk up right before the men. God is calling us like he did the church of Ephesus. We must be able to control our emotions. Be strong in the Lord and in his word. Have an unquestionable character and a remarkable conduct. We must be able to exemplify our faith and trust in the Lord and be willing to be in submission to his will. Our minds must be stable and in all ways and not letting everything enter our ear and eye gates. Which means sometimes you have to turn off the TV.
All right, now.
Sometimes you have to turn off the radio.
Come on.
Yes.
Sometimes you can't be on Facebook
Come on,
all the time.
Say it.
Sometimes you can't read everybody's comments. Yes. Sometimes you have to hide stuff so it won't be in your sight every
That's
day.
That's it. Say it.
Because what comes in the ear and the eye gaze will come out of the heart
before
you even know it. It's that we must be aware of people that come to deceive us and his people. And finally, the final lesson is, will you pray? Will you pray at all times? And to conclude this topic, I want you to think on this scripture. Psalms 22 and 26 and 2, it says, examine me, O Lord, and prove me, and try the reins of my heart. It's examination time. Will you pass?
Amen.